watching High School Playbook, powered by WXII 12.
Everybody, and welcome to High School Playbook, along with Craig Thomas. I'm Dave Gordon. Don't forget highschoolplaybook.com as well. Scripts are a little light tonight.
Mostly nothing. Mostly rainouts, mostly postponements. However, we do have a couple squads. We have one squad here with a couple games that we will definitely show you the best highlights. Really, the only highlights we have in the entire area.
That's right. It rains a lot. A lot of games get postponed. Do we not do our show?
We're here. That's here, right. Every Friday night, High School Playbook. You have to be here.
And you know what? Follow me down here, Shimon. The ground's dry. I think we should have played a lot more games tonight.
I think it stopped raining about 8 o'clock in the Forsyth County area.
We could have played.
Yeah.
All right, let's get to our...
We
would have played. We might play later. Let's get to our game of the week. Forsyth Country Day at South Davidson. This one in Denton. FCDS coming in 0-3, so are the Wildcats. Hit of the night right here. Ryan Aaron on the carry. Nick Sink knocks him down.
Then we have a bit of history. Jordan Smith up the middle. He breaks a tackle there. He moves to the outside there. And he is going 91 yards. That is the longest in FCDS history. It is 7-0 just like that.
Wildcats take possession, but they don't take it for long because Barrett Clodfelder intercepted right there. Dixon Pitt with the pick. Say that three times fast, but 10.
And I won't even try. Now, there was a little luck tonight for the team in white. Jordan Smith runs towards the end zone. But he drops the ball right there. It's a fumble, but his brother, Gray Smith, falls on the ball in the end zone. That is a touchdown. South Davidson coach says, no, it's not. But you know what? It is. It counts. It's 14-0.
They're brothers. They've done that before. Wildcats try to get tricky. Double reverse, but Tucker Nelson says, Drew Hill, you are going nowhere. In fact, you're going to take the loss.
Now, here is the Wildcats' best play of the night. Interception by Ryan Aaron. Then the umbrellas come out. It does start to rain a little bit.
But once the rain starts, the Furies continue to dominate. Watch Seth Constable. He's going to break a tackle after he catches the pass, and he is gone. That touchdown makes it for South Country Day 21, South Davidson nothing, and they're not done yet.
The man who started the scoring finishes the scoring on this Friday night, Jordan Smith. Nice move to the outside. There he goes. The Furies win their first game of the season. The final score, 28.
They are excited, and their head coach joining us, no stranger to folks in our area, Rusty LaRue, former star at Wake Forest, now football coach, basketball coach, and athletic director at Forsyth Country Day. Big win for you guys tonight.
It was. We came into the game 0-3. We played some good football, played some good teams. Fortunately, tonight we played well and came up with a win.
You told me before we went on, you guys should have scored some more points.
Yeah, we did. I mean, we played a little bit sloppy. The weather wasn't that great, but we took advantage of our opportunities. We had them. Defense played phenomenal. They've played well for the last couple of weeks, but we got a lot of work to do offensively.
You lost a couple guys, transferred out. How did you make it good with these guys?
Well, I think the kids we've got here are great kids. They work hard every day in practice. They put their helmets on every day, go out there, work hard. We've had a tough schedule. We've played two of the top teams in the state the last 2 weeks in the 3A private. So it was nice to get a win, get on track, getting ready for conference.
I think I've asked you this before. I'm going to ask again. You have what, four kids, right? Four kids, football coach, the basketball coach, athletic director. You run the summer pro-am basketball league. How do you keep it all straight?
I have great assistant coaches and great help out of Forsyth Country Day School. That's how I do it.
And you better say great wife.
And a great wife. Don't forget about that. She's probably watching at home. Hopefully my kids are in bed. But hopefully her wife's watching. So we get 9 o'clock in the morning, Forsyth County Broncos versus Colonel Raiders. I'll be there.
There you go. Next up for you guys is who?
We've got at home versus Hickory Grove, which is our first conference game. So Spirit Week for us next week. So it's a big week.
All right, Russ LaRue, thank you very much. Congratulations.
All right, thanks a lot.
Big win tonight for the Forsyth Country Day Furies. And they're pretty excited.
It's amazing how that works. On cue, you have such power.
It's so good. Told you, most of the games in our area postponed tonight. We're going to take a look at some of those games right now.
Beginning with the ones that are going to be moved to tomorrow. The games tomorrow afternoon at McGinnis. They'll start at noon. At 1 o'clock, the kick at Forbush. Atkins and Reagan, East Wilkes and North Stokes, those are tomorrow night.
Same for Martinsville, Moorhead at Eden, and Graham Williams in Burlington. Southeast, Northwest Guilford at 7, West Stokes, North Surrey at 7:30.
Southern Guilford, Southwestern Randolph, 7, East Burke, Starmount, 7:30. 7:30, North Rowan, Thomasville, and Ragsdale at Grimsley.
One other game tomorrow night on this side of the border. That would be Andrews and Central, the Battle of High Point at Simeon Stadium. That one kicks at 6. And a couple of Virginia games, Craig. Radford at Grayson start at 1:30. If you want to do the day-night doubleheader, you have Auburn, Galax at 7:30.
Weather should be fine, so all those games should go on no problems tomorrow.
That's right. We have more highlights, believe it or not, to show you for Forsyth Country Day. The winners of our game of the week will be back on High School Playbook right after.